Hey, Most Amazing Top 10 family, I'm your host, Chade Rain, and welcome back to Most Amazing Top 10. I have been feeding you guys with tons of SCP info lately, and you guys just love it so much. I have to be honest, I am pretty beginner when it comes to knowing all this deep, dark backstory stuff when it comes to the SCPs and how they operate, but that's why I love doing these videos, because I get to learn so much about the extensive writing project on the internet known as the SCP Foundation. This time, we're going to be looking into some of the top 10 scary SCP monsters from parallel universes. If any of you at home want some Most Amazing Top 10 merch, you should check out the link in the description below and use the offer code MA10 to get $5 off, which means you can grab a shirt for only 10 bucks, which is a sweet deal. And stick around for the whole list, because I'm going to be doing some more pet shoutouts at the end of this video. Remember, if you want me to shout out your pet, you can hit me up on Instagram. And right before we get into this list of SCPs, I got to give a shout out to our amazing sponsor. And of course, I'm talking about World of Warships. Do you want the perfect blend of action and strategy gameplay? Something you can call a thinking man's game? Well, then we've got the perfect game for you here, and it is World of Warships. It has some of the most iconic battle vessels from history, and you'll get to control an entire fleet of them. World of Warships also has so much to offer. New game content will drop each week, and there are also over 30 million players worldwide who have already jumped in. So how much does this cost you to get into this amazing game known as World of Warships? How about it's a free-to-play game? There is zero barrier to entry. You can get into this game right now by clicking the registration link in the description below. And because this game is packed full of so much content, it might take some time to download. So the best thing to do is to start downloading this game overnight, have it ready first thing in the morning. When you sign up, use the invite code ReadyForBattle2020, and every new player will receive the following: 700 doubloons, World of Warship premium membership for 7 days, 1 million credits, 2 premium battleships, the USS Charleston with Star and Stripes custom camouflage, and the Japanese ship Ishizuki and Lunar Warrior custom camouflage for that ship. So what are you waiting for? Get into World of Warships today. And now we're gonna get into this video. At number 10, we have SCP-1322. Could you imagine looking through a hole and seeing into another dimension that seems better than our own? That would really get me cheese. This SCP has also been known as the Glory Hole. Yes, I know this is a gross nickname, but it is for a very good reason. It is a small hole that leads to a much better destination than a traditional glory hole would. It is a 1 centimeter in diameter hole that seems to look into another world, a world that is very similar to our own, but much more advanced when it comes to technology. It seems to be a world filled with humans like our own, but there is a downside though. I mean, this is the SCP Foundation we're talking about, so of course there is always a few downsides. This other world has not made advancements when it comes to medicine. The reason for this is unknown. It could be because they simply do not value health, or there could be some sort of disease that prevents them from becoming healthier. Even though there's mostly humans on the other side of this glory hole, it seems like there could also be monstrosities as well. At number 9, we have SCP-093. This SCP is a key, but to where? Well, it depends on who is holding it. It will lead you to a dimension much like our own, but possibly with much stronger religious control. Who knows? Each dimension it could lead you to is very different. The SCP looks like a red disc, but has markings on it that are unknown by any human. These markings haven't been linked to any type of civilization. If you put SCP-093 down on a flat surface, it will start to move on its own and find the nearest mirror. It will then connect to this mirror, and this is how it's able to open up portals to other dimensions. If SCP-093 is being held, it will change colors depending on who's holding it. The color change will lead to different alternate dimensions. It is unknown how to control the color change of SCP-093. There are dimensions that can be connected to that have creatures in them that will harm anyone who comes in contact with them. At number 8, we have SCP-507, also known as the Smiling Man. This SCP seems to just be a normal man who likes to be called the following names: Tommy, Steve, Houdini, and Garbanok the Destroyer. It's that last one that makes me freak out a little bit, because this is not just a normal man. This SCP has the ability to teleport to an alternate dimension and then return. Seems that the SCP has some control over this, but for the most part, it is random. There is an extensive catalog of information on what these alternate dimensions look like and the people that SCP-507 meets over there. This SCP has been classified as safe because it hasn't tried to harm anyone and is even asked permission to teleport to other dimensions before it has done this. One reason was to visit another SCP and then came back with a relatively boring story. But that's why I don't trust this dude. What if he brings back a massive monster? I'm not into it. No one who can teleport can be that boring. At number 7, we have SCP-1437, an endless hole that will sometimes puke up cool stuff. enough, there have been a number of inanimate objects that have flown out of this SCP. For the most part, it's nothing too interesting, like dirt and rocks. But one of the most useful things that have come through this SCP are a skyline photo of New York. This show New York as a completely different city. This could confirm that through this SCP, there is a gate to another version of our reality that could be drastically different. One of the most alarming things that has come through this SCP is a note that said, "Please send rain." This could mean that across this dimensional rift, there's a version of Earth that has a massive drought and could be about to die. Well, at least we're not on that side. At number 6, we have SCP-1936. The town of Daleport, New England was just a regular place until a massive gaseous cloud covered it, and it was thought that it was housing another dimension. It was in 1997, and the SCP Foundation could not enter the town at this time because of the gaseous cloud. But X-ray radiographs have shown some strange imagery. It looks as if there was humanoid creatures that had octopus-like tentacles in place of their feet. It's unknown if these humanoid creatures passed through a dimensional rift into the town, or if it was the gaseous cloud that was causing mutations in the people of Daleport. Most of the people present in the town during this time committed suicide. At number 5, we have SCP-2639. This SCP will cover a 1 kilometer area in what seems to be a cubic force field and open up a rift into another dimension. Three humanoid creatures known as SCP-2639-A will appear. It's unknown how to communicate with these beasts, but they seem destructive in nature. They have super speed, super strength, and agility. And any sort of weapons used on SCP-2639 seem to have no effect. They can damage it, but they do not react in any sort of way that showcases a feeling of pain. If enough damage is done to one of these three humanoid creatures, they will dissolve and another one will appear in their place, completely regenerated with no signs of damage. They cannot leave the cubic space. It will last for approximately 1 to 2 hours and then vanish. At number 4, we have SCP-1171, a house SCP. How nice. It seems like this house may be a portal to another dimension or form of communication to another dimension. Condensation will appear on the windows of this house at all times, regardless of the external or internal temperature. Through condensation was the discovery of SCP-1171-1. This is a creature that will write on the condensation but cannot be heard, seen, or felt in any way. If you write back on the condensation, you may communicate with this beast. It goes by the name Boromont, and it has a hatred for all human life. Well, good thing he's on the other side of that dimensional portal, and hopefully he'll never come over to us. At number 3, we have SCP-XXXX. At first glance, this SCP seems just to be a normal human. He even goes by a human name, Grady Evans. But after closer inspection, this SCP seems to be a human from parallel universe and is extremely powerful. If SCP-XXXX touches you, it has the ability to take you to its dimension, and if this SCP ever feels threatened, it can disappear into a place in between dimensions for safety. When it goes into the place in between dimensions, it can use telepathy to communicate with other people from its own dimension. It's safe to say you don't want to let this SCP get close to you at any time. At number 2, we have SCP-106, the old man. This creature is from an unknown origins, but it's thought that it could be from a pocket dimension that it sometimes escapes to. It seems that this pocket dimension could be a parallel universe to our own, or simply a place where SCP-106 stores its food. Its food, which is almost always people. This SCP has been called the old man because it does look like an elderly man with some major differences. Its entire body seems to be rotting. It also produces some sort of acid-like substance out of its body that can break down solid material or flesh. If this SCP comes in contact with you, it will almost certainly attack you, usually disemboweling you before it takes you to a pocket dimension. Once you are in this other dimension, it's almost guaranteed that you will not return. At number 1, we have SCP-2682. At first glance, this SCP seems to only be a Korean strawberry that has the ability to communicate through telepathy, but after extensive conversation, it was determined that this SCP is one of the most powerful creatures across dimensions and simply became stuck. It was a philosopher from another dimension who worked with other philosophers. They studied the occult and gained the power to trap God. They then performed experiments on God and gained all of its knowledge, all the knowledge it possessed about their universe. After that, they became bored and crossed between dimensions to collect knowledge from all other dimensions. After doing this, SCP-2682 transformed and became stuck. It's unfamiliar with our dimension and the laws of reality. It does not know how to free itself and desperately would like to leave. It's unknown how to set this creature free, and if released, it's unknown what kind of effect it would have on our reality. Alright everyone, that has been our list, and as promised, I'm going to be doing some more pet shoutouts. Remember, if you want me to shout out your pet, you can hit me up on Instagram. I pick new pets every day, so if you don't get picked one day, you can message back another day. If it takes me a little while to get back to you, I am very sorry, because I got a lot of these to do, and without taking any longer, let's shout out some pets. First off, we got the silly cat Panda Oreo. This guy knows how to party. I can tell that he does it a lot. Next, we got Remy, who is decked out in a great costume. You're looking very good, Remy. I love it. Then we have Dio Brando, who has been named the Destroyer of Toys, and you can see why. After that, we have Bosco, who is living out our Sunday morning dreams and just rolling around in bed. I want to do that right now. And to wrap it up, we have Athena. Boxers are so great, super hyper dogs. I love being around them. Great snugglers too. All right, everyone, that has been our list. Thank you all so much for tuning in. I would love it if you guys could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. Until next time, I've been your host, Chade Arena, and I guess don't touch any SCPs or you'll die. Bye. Thank you.